I'm sorry. I wouldn't be very good company right now.
Let's trade.
I know I'm not the only person here who's lost someone. I miss him so much.
Thank you. this place is starting to feel like...
Right behind you.
This place is starting to feel like home. Now that we can grow, our trouble is, the more we establish ourselves.
Just looking to trade a little.
Well, this military stuff isn't exactly my specialty. I like turrets because they do the shooting for me, but I'm not picky.
Hey, Sturgis.
Thanks for doing that. We'll all sleep better at night knowing we have some defenses set up. It's been a long road. But yeah, I think this is it. Home. Feels good.
What next?
Well, I guess figuring out how to get back to living, instead of just surviving. Of course, you know you're welcome anytime. My door's always open to you. Windows, too. Some of the walls, actually, come to think of it. I guess I better get back to it. Take care now.
Hey, Piper.
What do you need?
Your thoughts?
Have any more questions about the Institute's enemy?
We should get going.
All right.
Miles on the road. At least the pay is
stick
terrible.
To the roads, and you got a better chance of surviving.
Come on now.
Was that you?
Thank you.
This is an emergency broadcast signal from Vault 88. Identification code word, Impish. Vault 88 emergency classification. Unspecified integrity breach warning. Any available Vault-Tec personnel are required to respond under emergency protocol VT-76. This signal will repeat.
Bingo.
Hey.
What you got for me? Looking for something specific?
Hey.
Where to? Help yourself. Blue, come on. Let me carry something before you cripple yourself.
That's it.
you're not an idiot.
Thanks. You too.
No, I didn't mean like... I could just use some help. This isn't the sort of thing I'd normally bother anyone else with, but with my sister, Nat, becoming me.
Wait, become you? Like, replace you? Oh, is Nat a synth?
Oh, well, there's something I'm gonna lose sleep over for days, but no, not like a synth. More like, she's gonna start following in my perilous footsteps.
I mean, think about the life we lead. No offense intended, Blue, but personal safety doesn't exactly seem like either of our strong suits.
I can't have her ending up like her big sister. Dodging bullets and running from all the people she pisses off. It's part of the reason I'm on the road so much. Part of the reason I'm here with you. I keep thinking, maybe if I make myself scarce, if I'm not around her enough, cool off. She'll just go back to being sweet, innocent Nat, paper girl, and all-around upstanding citizen. What do I do, Blue?
So you're here to get away from Nat?
Well, I mean, there are other reasons. Right now, the only thing I can think about is Nat. What do you think I should do?
You just love her. Family's precious. The last thing you want to do is drive them away, because you might lose them forever.
You're right. I can't risk that. Thanks, Blue. Who'd expect wandering off with a stranger to turn out this well? They really don't make them like you anymore. You're a hell of a friend, you know that?
Just friends, huh?
Well, yeah. I guess, but I thought so. Unless, you know, something changes. God, did it get hot in here? But hey, thanks again for listening. It's a real weight off my chest to be able to talk it out with someone. So, you wanna hit the road?
Hey.
Shoot. If you wanted to make me a second print, what'd they use you for? Nothing but garbage.